to my channel. Today we're going to be looking at the topic of electrolysis. First, let's define the word electrolysis. Electrolysis can be split up into two parts, electro and lysis. Electro relates to electricity. Lysis means to split. Electrolysis is used to split up ionic compounds into their elements. This is only possible under certain conditions. Let's look at this diagram. The first condition that we require is that we use DC electricity. This means that one of the electrodes will be positive and one of the electrodes will be negative. This allows for separation of charge so that the positive ions and negative ions can be separated. The second requirement is that we need to have a solution or a molten ionic compound. This means that the ions will be free to move. Let's look at an example to explain how this works. In the beaker, we have copper chloride solution. This means that within the solution, we have copper 2 plus ions, and we have chloride 1 minus ions. We have positive and negatively charged electrodes. The copper 2 plus ions will be attracted to the negative electrode, whereas the two chloride ions will be attracted to the positive electrode. At the negative electrode, the copper 2 plus ions will pick up two electrons and become copper solid. This means that we will see a brown solid forming on the electrode. At the positive electrode, the two chloride ions will lose their electrons that make them negatively charged ions to become chlorine gas and two electrons. As we have a gas produced, we will see bubbles of gas at the electrode. You would also be able to smell the chlorine gas. This equation here for the copper gaining electrons is called a reduction equation. For the chloride ions, we have an oxidation equation. Pause the video now and explain what you would see and write the ion electron equations for this example. In this example, we have magnesium fluoride solution. This means that in the solution, we have magnesium ions and fluoride ions. The magnesium ions will be attracted to the negative electrode, and the fluoride ions will be attracted to the positive electrode. At the negative electrode, the magnesium ions will pick up two electrons to become magnesium solid. At the negative electrode, you will see a silvery solid being produced. At the positive electrode, the two fluoride ions will lose two electrons and become fluorine gas. You will see bubbles of gas at the electrode. Thank you for watching my video. I hope that you found it helpful. Please remember to subscribe if you've not already and ring the bell to be notified of new videos. You can also follow me on Twitter at Miss Adams Chem for regular updates on new videos, and Instagram Miss Adams Chemistry for flashcards throughout the year. Bye for now!